Good morning, boys and girls, and welcome to our last virtual chapel. At least that's how I have it planned today, because next Wednesday we're going to be in the church and we'll be worshiping all together, socially distanced as classrooms, but we'll be having our final chapel of the year in the church. So I'm looking forward to that. But today we have a virtual chapel with our fifth grade class, and we'll be talking about the shoes that need to be fitted for our feet to be able to go and spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. You know, when Jesus ascended into heaven, that was last Thursday, we celebrated that. Ascension Day was last Thursday. Jesus gave his disciples the Great Commission. He said, go into all the world, all nations, baptizing them, teaching them, and telling them everything that I have told you over these last 3 years. And remember, all authority has been given to Jesus over heaven and in earth. And he wanted the disciples to know that he would be with them at all times, and that he expected them to put on those shoes or those sandals and go out into the world. So today we're going to be looking at the right fitted shoes for our feet to be able to do the work that God has made us for. Ephesians says, we are made in the handiwork of God to do the work that has been set before us. And we run the race. We run the race to help others gather together in God's love. So today we're going to be looking at some running shoes and maybe not so much running shoes, and trying to understand how we can go out and spread the gospel of Jesus Christ to others. So let's get started.
Let us begin in the name of our God, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
This reading is from Hebrews 12:1. Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders us and the sin that so easily entangles us, and let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us.
This reading is from Ephesians 6:14-15. Stand firm then with the belt of truth buckled around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, with your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of God's peace in Jesus Christ.
So we now have a responsive reading from Psalm 119, verses 27 through 32. And Lily is going to be the leader in the reading, and all the children, and we'd like to invite everyone else, please, to join with us in the refrain that is in bold. Let us begin.
Cause me to understand the way of your precepts, that I may meditate on your wonderful deeds.
My shoes are tied and ready to run.
My soul is weary with sorrow. Strengthen me according to your word.
My shoes are tied and ready to witness your love.
Keep me from deceitful ways. Be gracious to me and teach me your law.
My shoes are tied and ready to speak your word.
I have chosen the way of faithfulness. I have set my heart on your law.
My shoes are tied and ready to serve in your kingdom.
I hold fast to your statutes, Lord. Do not let me be put to shame.
My shoes are tied and ready to do your work.
I run in the path of your commands, for you have broadened my understanding.
Lead me, Lord, to proclaim your gospel of peace to others.
This next reading is from Joshua 1:9. The Lord speaking to Joshua as he prepares to lead God's people into the promised land. Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go.
So today, boys and girls, we are looking at shoes, appropriate shoes, seeing to see shoes that are there for our wearing. Some shoes are appropriate for running a race and some are not. So as we go down the line here, we're going to see some shoes that people have brought today. We have shoes that are matching and unmatching, some that are not. I gotta get out of the way here. Some that are here, good. Got those shoes, very good. So we're gonna be using some shoes and trying to figure out which shoes are gonna be appropriate for our running. The first one is gonna be a sprint. Do I have my runners ready on the line? Yeah. Great. Unfortunately, nobody has on shoes that are appropriate to run. Runners, take your marks. Set, go. Great. They ran the race. Come over here and line up. I want Bentley to go first, then Levi, just like we did in our order from sock run. Sock slide. We're doing what's called a staggered run. We're going to run around the gym. I have placed the race before you. But now remember this. Remember this. This race that we're running is not a race that we're trying to beat anybody in this group. All of us are running the same race that is laid out before us. What we're trying to do is finish the race. Now, some people are going to have a hard time finishing the race. Those are the struggles we have to deal with when we are running the race. We're distracted. Satan wants us to get off the race. He wants us to try to stop the race. He doesn't want us to finish the race. He doesn't want us to bring the gospel of peace. So you guys ready to run the race?
Yeah!
But look at your feet. They got socks on.
Yes.
Socks.
Yeah. I'm broke.
Barefooted. Socks.
I don't have
barefooted.
I'm broke. I have no money. I can't buy shoes.
Yeah, I'm broke.
I can't buy shoes because I'm broke.
Oh, whoa.
I don't know how this... I got the race set out before you, but I don't know if you're going to be able to make it.
I'm slapping the chair again.
All right. Are you ready to go?
Yes.
Go.
Oh,
stay around the cone. Around the cone.
Where are they? Sure is taking them a long time to get around. Maybe they got distracted. Maybe they don't have the proper footwear. Wonder when they're going to cross the finish line.
Come over here and line up. I want Bentley to go first, then Levi, just like we did in our order from sock run. Sock slide. Once you finish the race, I want to go out there and help the other people, encourage them. You can do it. Come on. You can finish the race. We're taking one lap to finish the race. You are running outside of these little cones. And Madison's going to be here waving the checkered flag for the finish line as you finish the race. But I'll have some people that are going slow. So when you finish the race, if you can go around and go back over to them and encourage them. Don't push them. Don't grab them and pick them up. Encourage them. You can do it. Come on. Come on. Finish the race. Finish the race. I want everyone to finish the race. And I want her to wave the finish line for everyone to finish the race. Okay. You ready? Go, 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 go. Wave them in. Wave them in. They're finishing the race. Finishing the race. Finishing the race. Finishing the race. Great. And we finished the race. Give yourself an applause. Yay!
Woohoo! You finished! Good job! You finished the race! Victory!
This next verse comes from Matthew 20:19.
Jesus spoke to his disciples, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, to the very end of the age."
This next reading is from Acts 20:24. St. Paul says, "However, I consider my life worth nothing to me. My only aim is to finish the race and complete the task the Lord Jesus has given me, the task of testifying to the good news of God's grace."
Please join us in praying the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
This last reading comes from Ephesians 2:10. "For we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepares in advance for us to do."
Please join us for our closing prayer. Dear Jesus, thank you for calling me to work in your kingdom. Please fit me with the proper shoes to run the race of faith and proclaim the gospel of peace to others. In your name we pray.
Amen.
Runners, take your marks. Set, go!